On the left, on the right. Ooh, all night. Hello everybody, what's going on? Yes, another beautiful Monday here in the Fire Lawson Bears, and I have a pen on my hand. In my hand, not on my hand. The pen is on my hand. The pen is in my hand. I tend to do that a lot, I don't know why. Anyways, let's jump into the questions everybody asked last week. We are Tuesday Bear Joe, he asked us, you know, what kind of happy thoughts do you usually get whenever we're down? Thoughts that will make us feel better. And honestly, for the past couple days it's been rain, and it's always been rain. I love the rain, it makes me feel so, I don't know, it brings the good side out of me. Puts me in a good mood, and especially today I had a bad day at work. The rain made it a lot better, so I'm very happy because it's raining. Just, I don't know, something about the rain I really, really love. Which also is one of my personal things that Thursday asked to share three personal things that people do not know about you. That's one of them. I love the rain. I just love the rain. Oh man, I love the rain. Our Wednesday Bear, he asked us, well, here you go. Hey girl, hey! Okay, so jumping back into our Thursday Bear questions, share three personal things about yourself. And I have to say, as I mentioned, one of the things that people do not know about myself, as I mentioned, is that I love the rain. I love the rain, brings me into such a good mood. I love it. I just, every time that it's raining, I just love the smell of the rain and the sound of the rain. It's just so relaxing to me, so that's one. Number two is I hate bugs and I hate lizards with a passion. You guys have no idea. I cannot see a bug or a lizard because that just freaks the shit out of me. I just can't stand the sight of both two things, so yeah. And number three is I try to change things a lot about myself. It's very, very personal, but I tend to be a lot of I tend to be very insecure about myself sometimes, and you know, I've grown and I've, you know, changed a lot throughout, like, you know, at least for the past couple of years, and still sometimes I find myself to be very harsh on myself, and you know, I try to change and I try to think about it differently, but you know, it's tough. So yeah, insecurities in life. So yeah, that's my number three. And finally, our Friday Bear, he asked us to share our favorite male and our favorite female superheroes. And superhero female, Wonder Woman, in a heartbeat. I remember playing Wonder Woman with my younger brother when I was younger. We used to play something called Wonder Man, and we used to like turn around in circles and turn into Wonder Man, and it was funny. I should have seen that coming, right? Yeah, it was funny. And male superheroes, I always loved Robin. I don't know, he's the underdog. I really, really liked him. I thought he was very cute. And I don't know, I always used to love Robin for some reason, so yeah, that's my answer. Okay, for my question of the week, and it's kind of sort of related to a question that I asked a couple weeks ago, but this time it's related with games, sports games, and for you, which sports game is the gayest to you? Like, it's so gay, not like it's so gay as bad, but it's like, so homo-friendly. I personally have to say, after watching the World Cup, I think that's very gay. They're very friendly, those soccer players are very, very friendly, and yeah, they're not really bad looking either, so yeah. I know rugby, a lot of people say rugby, and I think that's kind of gay, kind of hot and gay at the same time, so I'm between the rugby and football, soccer, so. Which is your favorite sports game that you might think is very gay? Just let me know. Other than that, you guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next week.
On July 5th, 1946, French designer Louis Riard unveiled a daring two-piece swimsuit at the Piscine Molitieux, a popular swimming pool in Paris. Parisian showgirl Micheline Berardini modeled the new fashion, which Riard dubbed bikini, inspired by a news-making U.S. atomic test that took place off the Bikini Atoll in the Pacific Ocean earlier that week. That it's